Former Bamban Mayor Alice Goy is grilled again in the Senate over her true identity and her alleged connection to illegal pogos. Despite piling evidence against her, Goy maintains she is a Filipino and not Chinese, or not Chinese national, Gu Huaping. Now, Goy also evading questions of senators on her claim of alleged threats to her life.
Are you Gu Huaping?
Madam Chair, may mga kaso na po na final po sa akin po sa court, kaya hindi ko po siya masagot po sa inyo ngayon.
Hindi naman kayo may incriminate, simpleng tanong kung sino ka. And the addition, unless hihingi pa tayo ng executive session, no? Lilipat pa kami kasama nyo sa ibang kwarto para lang masagot nyo sino ba kayo talaga. Identity questions are within the purview of the committee. The Senate has a right to know.
Alam ko po, ako po si Alice Coco. At pasensya na rin po kung hindi po kayo naniniwala. Ako sinasabi ko, as much as possible po, gusto ko rin pong sabihin po sa inyo lahat at sa mga magiging questions niyo rin po sa akin mamaya. May consideration lang din po ako sa safety ko rin po. Magsasabi po ako, wag lang po in public.
Ghost remarks drew outrage from senators who accused the former mayor of lying. She was once again cited in contempt by the upper chamber.
Opening pa lang, nagsisinungaling na. Alam naman nating lahat na may mga ahensya ng gobyerno na nagbigay ng mga birth certificate at inamin na nila ng PSA sa mga dayuhan at kasama siya doon.
Sasagutin mo kaming ganyan, pagkataas mo kaming bastusin, pagkataas mo kaming takasan, sasabihin mo may death threat ka, tapos di mo masabi kung saan galing yung death threat mo. Hindi mo masabi kung dito sa Pilipinas o sa abroad.
You are only being asked about your previous answers to the committee. Please stop being evasive. Stop being evasive before this committee.
Goy also claims she fled the country via boat, a yacht, and a port here in Metro Manila. She, however, refused to name the owner of the yacht publicly. Senators have moved to take custody of the former mayor. Before today's hearing, Goy was under the custody of the PNP after she opted not to post bail on her criminal cases filed before a Tarlac court. Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. sacks Immigration Chief Norman Tansingco over the escape of ex-Mayor Alice Goy from the country. Tansingco's dismissal was confirmed by the palace as he attended the Senate probe of Goy's illegal flight to Indonesia. Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla today said he recommended to the president that Tansingco will be dismissed from office. He also wanted the immigration chief out over the agency's alleged issuance of visas to fake corporations. Mr. Marcos earlier vowed that heads will roll after Goy slipped past through Philippine authorities in Indonesia, where she was arrested by law enforcement there.
This has been a big problem for the longest time. We have not been lacking in reminders to the immigration commissioner about these problems. And I'm sorry to say, but I don't think he really has acted on them seriously.
Doomsday preacher Apollo Kibuloy and his co-accused presented to the media this afternoon. Kibuloy, with his face entirely covered, briefly made an appearance during a press conference of the Interior Department and the Philippine National Police. Authorities asserted Kibuloy surrendered because he had no choice since he was already surrounded by police inside the KOJC compound.
Yung pagsuko, formality na lang yun. At the end of the day, whether he likes it or not, the end result will ultimately be the same. So maybe he just chose the path na feeling niya ay mas magaan para sa kanya. And on our part naman, mas gusto naman natin na wala nang masaktan pang additional.
With all of these things na nangyari, I'm sure someone should be guilty of obstruction of justice for harboring, concealing, no, someone who is wanted by law.
Vice President Sara Duterte insisting she is not a spoiled brat after her controversial confrontation with House lawmakers during a recent budget hearing for her office. Duterte earned the ire of lawmakers for refusing to answer questions on her use of funds when she was Education Secretary. The daughter of former President Rodrigo Duterte says insinuations that she is a spoiled brat is part of a political attack against her and her family.
Alam ng taong bayan na hindi ako bratinela o spoiled brat dahil kilala nila ako simula nung ako ay nasa Davao pa, simula nung ako ay mayor pa, hanggang naging vice president ako. Kilala ako ng taong bayan na hindi ko inaabuso ang aking power and ang aking authority sa lahat ng mga opisina na nahawakan ko.